Webb has captured the light from a galaxy being bent. This is the best view ever of these strange, gravitationally warped halos of light. This image shows a phenomenon that occurs when light from a galaxy, star, or other light-emitting object passes near a massive object before it reaches us. As we know, very massive objects bend light, and this creates gravitational lensing, forming a ring-like effect that makes the light of the background object appear as an almost perfect ring. The background galaxy that Webb's near-cam instrument caught is called the SPT-S. You know what? Just call it JO418. This galaxy is about 12 billion light-years from Earth. Now that's distant. The whole universe is 13.7 billion years old. But why Einstein Ring? Well, that's because Albert Einstein, his theory of general relativity, predicted that gravity could bend light. Not only did the light from the background galaxy get bent, but it also got magnified. So this acts kinda like a natural zoom lens and helps us get more data. If it wasn't for this lensing effect, the galaxy would probably look like most distant galaxies, a small blob of light. The new image is not the first one of this galaxy, but it's the most detailed yet, owing to Webb's powerful capabilities. The first glimpse of this ring galaxy occurred in 2020 using the Atacama Large Millimeter Submillimeter Array, ALMA, in Chile. JO418 galaxy, shown as a ring, is oriented exactly behind another galaxy, the bright blue light at the center of the ring that is doing the bending of light. The image was processed on August 23rd by a Reddit member using publicly available data collected by the Mid-Infrared Instrument, MIRI, on the James Webb Space Telescope. He's known as SpaceGuy44, and his bio indicates that he's a graduate student of astronomy. This is the perfect example of citizen scientists helping polish this data. Webb's data is always public, and anyone can help. To get access to the data, simply go to mast.stsci.edu and go click on Advanced Search. Then, in the mission box, type JWST and press Enter. This will find an enormous amount of data, but if you're interested in a specific search, you can simply go to the object name, and if you want records for the Carina Nebula, just write NGC 3324 and press Search in the top left of the screen. On the left, you can see the instruments section, and you can check one or all of them. Finally, you can click the floppy disk icon on the left of each row to download the data. From here on, you need the correct software to open the FIDS files. Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.